Stage Left by Doug Lucie, 1985.
Oh, for crying out loud! Emma! Emma!
What?
Can you finish typing these minutes out? It's taking me forever. And I've run out of Tippex.
Well, I'm tidying the dressing room.
Why? That's stage management's job.
But it's a horrible mess, and you know I can't stand mess.
And I can't stand typing when I could be doing something useful.
Such as?
Reading scripts. I've got a pile a mile high to get through.
Well, get Alan and Saul to read some.
They'll want paying.
So? A fiver a script's hardly going to break the bank.
But I can't trust those two. You know how biased they are against certain types of plays and certain writers. They're like the Politburo when it comes to new writing.
Okay. Shift your backside.
Thanks, darling. We need a full-time secretary. I'll bring it up at the board meeting. Oh, and I've picked out some critics' quotes to put on the board out front.
Why? The show's sold out for the whole run.
Nothing wrong with showing off. Our first production in our own theatre's a runaway hit. I want to tell the world.
Darling, is an 80-seat box room over a pub, not the Old Witch.
But it could be the Old Witch. I mean, all the producers of books since the reviews came out, who knows?
I suspect they'll find an excuse not to take it in. Too left wing, too expensive, no stars in it, too much bad language and nudity, and take your pick.
Ah, a boy can dream.
How many times have we had West End producers sniffing round our shows?
A few.
And how many transfers have we had?
We came close with Alan's last one.
Yeah. Close, but no cigar.
But now we've got a permanent home, we're established.
Well, it's only permanent if the Arts Council agrees our grant. Well,
Frank says he's got all that sewn up. He should be getting the nod from Toby at lunch today.
Yeah, Frank's full of wind and piss.
He's good with figures, though. Mind you, he's changed a bit since university days. I think I preferred him when he was a Liberal. Liberal as in no political viewpoint whatsoever. Nice and cosy. What do you think?
Sorry, darling, wasn't listening. There. All done.
Oh, thanks.
Oh, did you feed the cat?
When?
This morning?
No, you always feed him.
But I asked you to, don't you remember?
Not sure.
I was busy unclogging the sink. Don't you remember that?
I was busy too.
Robert, you weren't busy. You were reading The Guardian.
To be more precise, I was reading a piece on political theatre and the miners' strike. Quite important, really.
And what did it say?
Oh, the usual Liberal bollocks.
Exactly. Still, I'd rather you were reading The Guardian than Newsline.
I only ever take it for the racing page.
In Newsline? I wonder what those crazy trots are up to now.
Well, there are rumours of a split. The Central Committee's divided over the behaviour of the party general secretary.
Quelle surprise.
I know.
Thank God you saw the light and escaped that bunch when you did.
And some. What was I thinking?
You weren't thinking, you silly man. That's the whole point.
I was a revolutionary. Thinking was a superfluous bourgeois distraction.
You, a revolutionary. You're many things, Robert, but a revolutionary. Come off it.
I was 20 years old and idealistic. I like to think I've matured in the intervening years.
You just wanted somebody to tell you what to think and do.
Yes, and now I have you to do that.
Mm. That poor bloody cat. He'll probably have died of malnutrition by the time we get home tonight.
You do realise he gets fed at almost every house in the street, don't you? Disloyal beast.
That's his survival strategy.
I hate cats.
Really? I'd never have known.
Hello, you two.
Hi, Frank.
How'd it go?
Oh, pretty well. The lunch was bloody awful, but Toby was on fine form. Had some very juicy gossip.
Do tell.
My lips, I'm afraid, are sealed.
So when do we get their decision?
Next week. And I must say, I'm highly optimistic. Toby was very impressed with our audience figures and projections. Though he did feel we should have a more mixed bag of plays lined up. You know, some that don't just relentlessly bang the left-wing drum.
Frank, just remember, we're not called Stage Left Theatre Collective for nothing. There's more than just a hint of political intention to our name.
Yeah, I get that, and it served us well for 3 years as a touring company, landing on and preaching to the converted in various parts of the country. But now we're settled down, as it were, in a permanent home, we need to build a loyal local audience. And there aren't enough dyed-in-the-wool lefties in this part of London to do that. Look, Toby feels, and I agree with him, that a programme of purely lefty propaganda isn't the most appetising fare to attract the floating punter.
Lefty propaganda?
Yes.
Like Profit, which is currently enjoying a sold-out run?
Yes. I mean, just look at the title.
Profit?
It's anti-capitalist propaganda.
It's ironic. For what does it profit a man to gain the whole world and forfeit his soul?
Exactly. You pick one sentence out of millions in the Bible and extrapolate it to prove that Christ's message is anti-capitalist.
It is.
Absolute nonsense, with knobs on.
Frank, you're talking rot and you know it.
Look, the fact remains that if we were to slip a couple of uncontroversial crowd pleasers into the programme, our Arts Council grant will be as good as in the bank. Plus, we have to consider the company's brand image.
It's what?
Whether you like it or not, Stage Left is now a brand. Like Heinz or Schweppes.
We make plays, not baked beans.
But we have a small core customer base. They know and like what we deliver, but we have to broaden our appeal. We have to establish the Stage Left brand for a new era.
Do you know what he's on about?
Yes. And I'm thinking we should never have let him go on that business course.
Well, actually, it was a real eye-opener.
And is that how they talk? Core customer base, brand image.
New times, new lingo.
Dear God.
Newsflash, Robert. We are now an established company. We're in business. Therefore, we need to think and speak the language of business.
Oh, my God.
What?
You've become a Tory. What happened to nice liberal Frank? You know, the bloke who didn't really do politics.
It's a short step from liberal to libertarian, Robert. I've become somebody who wants to make things work. No more scheduling and producing on a wing and a prayer. We need a business plan that outlines our aims and objectives. We then need to achieve them. That way, the people who fund us will see that we mean business.
We've always done that, Frank. We've just never felt the need to dress it up at the latest conservative business speak.
You better get used to it, Emma. It's here to stay. Oh, God, here they come. Two planks and a passion.
The Internationale unites the human race.
Afternoon, comrades.
Saul.
Beer, anyone?
Alan, it's 3 o'clock in the afternoon.
I know, I'm a bit late getting started, aren't I?
And we're here for a board meeting, not a party.
Every board meeting's a party, Em. A riot of tedium and bureaucratic infighting. I live for board meetings, believe me.
Well, give it a miss then and let the grown-ups get on with it.
Yeah, you wish.
Look, just for once, can we do things properly?
Ooh, what did you have in mind?
A proper board meeting.
Oh, very, very dull.
And have us wearing top hats next.
Honestly, Frank, we're a radical theatre company. We don't do anything properly.
Well, you got that right.
Okay, shall we get the party started?
Where's Kenny?
Oh, he'll be in the workshop knocking up the set for the Falklands play. Our next trial.
How are rehearsals going?
Oh, swimmingly.
Good. Okay. Robert's in the chair.
No, he's not. He's standing up.
Bureaucratic protocol, Al. The chair is metaphorical.
Yeah, what isn't these days?
Very Samuel Beckett.
I was thinking more Pinter with a splash of Orson.
Well, you should be so clever.
The minutes, please, Robert.
Oh, the metaphorical minutes?
No, the actual minutes.
Just checking what genre we're operating in here.
Theatre of the absurd.
Oh, cheer up, Frank. You got Thatcher crushing the miners. What more do you want?
Plenty.
David Hare? Can we afford him?
Oh, God.
The minutes.
Right. These are the minutes of the meeting held on the blah, 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 blah.
Agreed.
Blah. The meeting accepted that the chair's use of the phrase lady and gentleman was both sexist and classist, and the correct form of address should be comrades.
Yes.
This was objected to by the finance director, and in the ensuing discussion, the terms Bonapartist revanchism and bourgeois deviationism were freely bandied about. The chair soon regained control of the meeting by the dazzling manoeuvre of pointing out that the bar was now open. So the meeting adjourned to the bar, where Mr. Green moved that we schedule a miners' benefit performance of Profit on the afternoon of blah, 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 blah.
Agreed!
However, the finance director felt this was too political a gesture, but retracted his objection when threatened by the writer in residence and the associate director with the use upon his person of one of the knobbly novelty condoms available from the vending machine in the gents' lavatory. And the motion was passed.
Yay!
Whereupon the artistic director announced her intention to get a round in, which she did, and the meeting duly concluded.
Hey! Those novelty condoms really are something else.
I know.
Robert, do you think we could move on?
Sorry, yeah. So how's it going with the benefit, guys?
Well, the cast are fine with it.
Apart from Eton educated Rowley double barrel tit face.
Yeah, apart from Eton educated Rowley, who wouldn't recognise class solidarity if it came up behind him with a novelty condom.
What's his problem?
Well, he's pretending it's a matter of conscience, but basically...
He hates the working class, privileged little git.
A point of order, Chair.
Oh, here we go.
Isn't the writer in residence, Oxford?
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.